Oliver was looking tired early January, so I took him to the doctors. I said he looked a bit pale and tired, and they thought, yeah, maybe he's anaemic, so we'll go for a blood test. So we went for a blood test, and that same night I got a phone call from LGI, one of the consultants, saying you need to bring him straight in. So the next morning we took him into LGI, and he had tests all day long, and on the Friday, the very next day, he was diagnosed with stage 4 neuroblastoma. So stage 4 neuroblastoma means that it's a childhood cancer. Stage 4 meaning that it has spread beyond the prime tumour. So Oliver's prime tumour just sits on his kidney, but it has spread into his bone marrow, his eye sockets, the back of his skull. Since then, Oliver started chemotherapy. He's coping really well with his treatments, but the neuroblastoma is high risk, which essentially means the chance of relapse is very, very high. So even if the treatment goes really well now, even if we reach the all clear stage of remission, the chance of it coming back are very high, over 60% chance. So we know about a clinical trial in America, which is designed to prevent the cancer from coming back. So that's what we're raising the money for. It will cost in the region of £230,000 to get us out there, the cost of the flights, the accommodation, the vaccine itself. It's more than one journey. It is a series of 7 vaccines, so we'll be backwards and forwards to America. So it's a lot of money, and obviously we don't have that kind of money lying around, so we're fundraising for it. So at the moment we have a Just Giving page set up. We've got a Facebook page all about Oliver's journey, and we've been doing local events, so local raffles, local like cake sales, tuck shop just down the road, just all local things. We have got some bigger events coming up, so starting next week just down at the cricket club, we've got a big auction coming up at Charleston Cricket Club. We've got like a big fun day organised. We have raffles, and we've got a charity ball. We've got all different events leading up throughout into the summer, all with the view of raising money. We think we've got about a year to raise the money in total, so we're going to try and spread the events out throughout the whole year. Local people who we don't even know have raised money for Oliver. They've done their own charity events, their own raffles, their own kind of auctions, and they've set up their own races and runs and things. And these are people we don't even know, that they live local. And we just want to thank everyone. We really, really are grateful.